I just want to do God's will. And he's allowed me to go up to the mountain. And I've looked over. And I've seen the promised land. I may not get there with you, but I want you to know tonight that we as a people will get to the promised land.
Dr. King was important because he stood for things that we all believed were significant. Better education, better jobs, better places to live.
When the revolution comes, transit cops will be crushed by the trains after losing their guns, and blood will run through the streets of Harlem, drowning anything without substance when the revolution comes.
And we had a gig at Lincoln University. Gil Scott was the student body representative, and he brought us on stage. And after we did our thing, Gil Scott came backstage and he asked me specifically, says, look, man, I want to start a group like you guys.
When the revolution comes, Afros gonna be trying to straighten their heads and straighten heads gonna be trying to wear Afros when the revolution comes.
So I didn't know what Gil did. I didn't have any idea of what he could do. All I knew is that he was an eager young brother who wanted to do what we were doing.
Important corner in Harlem, and Harlem was the most important city in Black America. And there was a poem that I'd written, and the poem was called Small Talk at 125th and Lenox. Picture a man of nearly 30 who appears twice as old, with clothes torn and dirty. Give him a job shining shoes or cleaning out toilets with bus station crews. Give him 6 children with nothing to eat and expose him to life on a ghetto street. Tie an old rag around his wife's head and have her pregnant lying in bed. Put all 8 people in a Harlem house and then tell them how bad things are down south.